This part will assume you have configured Unity and obtained the Katane mod kit from GitHub and are ready to go from there. If you haven't done that already, then go and watch part 1 of the Modding for Katane series, link in the card, and probably the description as well. Okay, so your machine is now ready to start developing mods for Katane. Let's start going through how to configure your mod and how to build and test the mod in Katane. Configuring your mod. First of all, let's make a copy of the Katane mod kit project folder for the new mod and rename the folder to what you want your mod to be named as. Then open up Unity and open the project folder that you've just created. Next, when Unity has finished loading up, go to the top menu bar in the editor and go to Keep Talking Mod Kit, Configure Mod. In the inspector window, generally on the right side of the editor in the default Unity layout, there will be some fields that need to be filled in. At this time, the only absolutely necessary fields that need to be filled in are the mod ID and mod title fields, so go ahead and fill those in now. The mod ID field is a computer-friendly name for the mod, generally without any spaces in the name if it's a multiple-worded mod name. Some authors add a prefix at the front of the ID to indicate them as the author, such as Spwizz for Spare Wizard, but this is entirely optional. Your mod ID could be Super Leak Killer Kappa Cop if you wanted to, but then no one will know what you're referring to anyway. The mod title field is a human-friendly name for the mod, with capitalization and spaces if you'd like. Again, I ain't going to tell you what to put in there. Building your mod. Once all of that is done, go back to the Keep Talking Mod Kit menu and go to Build Asset Bundle. Or if you're fancy or lazy, hit F6 on your keyboard, because it's a shortcut, you know.
Wow.
Then we play the waiting game. Not really, you don't actually have to wait that long before your mod is built. If you now check in your project folder under a new subfolder called Build, there should be a folder in there containing your mod. Congratulations, you've built your mod. If that didn't work, then check the console window in Unity to see if any errors come up. If you see this error come up, then you forgot to configure your mod, you dunderhead, testing your mod. Now it's time to test your mod out in Katane. But hang on, we haven't actually added anything into the mod yet, have we? Well, I'll come to that in a moment after we've tested the mod out, alright? In order to test your mod out, you need to move the folder containing your mod to where the Katane executable lives. For those on Steam, navigate to your Steam Apps folder, then Common, then Keep Talking and Nobody Explodes. Create a new folder here called Mods, and then move your mod folder into that mods folder you've just created. For those outside of Steam, then we probably can't help you out, since the modding support is only really provided in the Steam version of the game. Sorry! After you have moved your mod folder, then launch up Katane.
Pro tip!
If you are testing just your own local mods, then don't launch up the game through Steam, as that will load up any Steam Workshop mods that you are subscribed to, and that just makes life difficult, right? Instead, just launch up the EXE or app from within the Steam app directories. Since this isn't loaded up through Steam, it won't load the Steam Workshop mods, and will only load up your local mods instead. Told you it was a pro tip.
Amazing!
So after Katane has finished booting up and loading your mod, then all should be... What is all this? Why is the room all white? What is this grey block? Why is the bomb beep booping at me? The examples in the mod kit. The mod kit comes with examples of what you can mod with it, and by default, when you retrieve it from GitHub, all the examples are enabled in the built mod bundle. This is why the game looks like this when we've not really done anything with the mod. It's all the examples' fault. To fix this, close Katane, go back to your Unity window, and in the project window, do the following search term. b:mod.bundle. This will find everything in the assets for this project that is tagged with the specific bundle ID of mod.bundle, which the mod kit uses to figure out what should be built when you build the mod bundle. Now, select all the elements in the search pane below, then at the bottom of the inspector window over to the right, where it says Asset Bundle, click the drop down and choose None. This will stop all of those examples from being built into the mod bundle for future builds. Note though, if you now try and build the bundle, the bundler will throw up an error in the console, saying that there are no assets tagged for the mod bundle. So now you can't build anything until we've actually started making our own mod with the mod kit. Well, with all that done, you've now successfully configured your mod. And this is where the video series will fork out into various different things you can do with the mod kit. Use the links in the description to pick out what you want to do with the mod kit, and I'll see you in the next part.